Welcome to my channel. This reading is for those of you that have strongly Aquarius in your chart. Please have in mind that this is a general reading, so the messages that will come through may or may not resonate with you. If you are interested in a personal reading, all the information you need is below in the description box. Aquarius. Okay, so let's see. Aquarius. So you are in between worlds, you're juggling. You're juggling, Aquarius. You don't know what to do. Should you put effort, energy, time into this person, project, or not? I feel that you have some kind of history being the one that is initiating. You are the one that is trying to fix things, but okay, I feel that you don't want to do that anymore. I feel, Aquarius, that the just thing is for this person to, maybe for the first time, to be the one to pursue you, Aquarius, okay? So you have been going through healing, some kind of an awakening, Aquarius. Okay. Yes, the Ace of Swords. Let's see, Aquarius. Let's see, Aquarius. Yes, you are okay in a soulmate connection. This is a significant soulmate connection. But again, you are embodying the energy of the Empress, meaning that you, okay, the Empress is passive. The Empress waits for things to come to her. She's not like the Emperor. The Emperor is embodying the energy of action, okay? Okay. So, Aquarius, of course there are times that you're like, okay, I'm going to take a risk here and make that phone call, send that email. Maybe you are fearing, could be that you are fearing failure or disappointment or even rejection. Okay, Aquarius. And then you're like, okay, I'm not gonna take that risk. I'm not gonna call. I'm not gonna send the message. I'm just going to take things as they come. And I will keep manifesting in the hermit energy. I will keep manifesting what is best for me as an individual. Yeah. So again, you see that you are in between worlds, because one side of you, one part of you is like, okay, I'm gonna take the risk, I'm gonna do this, and then you're like, no, it's time for them to chase me. It doesn't sound very nice, chase me, but yes, again, one part of you wants to put effort and energy in this. The other part of you is like, no, I'm done with this. I'm not happy with this. So in a way, you are somehow turning your back to this person, to this situation. Okay, Aquarius. Done. We're done here. Let's see. Aquarius. So on the bottom of the deck, we have the Ace of Pentacles. Now, you are viewing, or you are about to start viewing, seeing different opportunities, different options. Maybe just options and opportunities are heading towards your way. And you're like, okay, why should I ignore this? Why? Yeah, okay. Excuse me. The Three of Cups. That is your energy, the Queen of Swords, Aquarius energy. Ten of Pentacles. Now, I'm also getting here that Aquarius, it could be that there is something coming towards your way that is distracting you or taking you away from your romantic issues. Something in your 3D reality could be that you are, it could be that there is a new opportunity in your career, or you are doing a lot of things, that a lot of things are occupying your time. This is like a blessing I'm hearing. It's a blessing, okay? Three of Wands. This is very nice. This is nice because I am seeing that something that you have been waiting for will come to fruition. But again, I feel that this has to do with your life, with your 3D life. Yes, something that you have been working hard for. Knight of Pentacles, Page of Swords. The Page of Swords is a message. Five of Swords and the King of Cups. Okay, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. King of Pentacles, Earth Energy, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. But again, I am seeing you here really focusing on your 3D reality, your future. There is also something that you're not seeing here. But you will face very soon. And it's actually is very good. Aquarius is positive. It's also this. I'm hearing this, like, it's very important that at times you see and value yourself and be like, tap yourself on the back and be like, look what I have accomplished. Okay? Because you are very powerful here. You are in your power. Okay? You have your home, your job, your career. I'm also hearing that you are loved, Aquarius. You are loved. So you have people, you have fans, Aquarius. You have your fans, your soul's group, your tribe that is there for you. But there is a sense of betrayal here with the Five of Swords. There is a sense of betrayal, a sense of loss. But it's very interesting because this energy is like turning. Like once upon a time, this felt like a betrayal to you, a sense of loss to you. And now it's like you're viewing things from a different perspective and you're like, no, this is not my loss. It's their loss because I am the King of Pentacles. I am the Nine of Pentacles. So it's their loss, not mine. Clarifying the Five of Swords for Capricorn. Sorry if I called you Aquarius. If I did, I'm sorry. Capricorn, no, you're Aquarius. Oh my goodness, I got confused now. You see what I mean? I did Capricorn earlier. Now I'm doing Aquarius. Thank you, Sophia. Concentrate. So, Aquarius. My goodness. Five of Swords. Why is the Five of Swords here for Aquarius? The sense of loss, of betrayal. Why? Yeah, okay, that's a big question mark. Why? I don't deserve this. You don't. Someone, I feel that this King of Cups here, that could be any sign, has acted in a very spontaneous, immature way, has made a very immature decision that obviously has affected you in a negative way. Okay? So I'm going to clarify this King of Cups. Aquarius. My goodness. Clarifying the King of Cups here. So who is this King of Cups that a part of you is waiting for them to return, it feels that you are waiting for them to return or waiting from them to ask for your forgiveness. Let's see. This King of Cups, please. I did say earlier that is the just thing for them is for them to come towards you. And yeah. They are aware of this. This King of Cups is aware, okay, that they are the one that should speak, that should initiate. Yes, they are the ones that have to come forward and speak their truth. Okay, so again, this is the just thing, the just way. Again, clarifying, please, the King of Cups with justice here. The King of Cups with justice. Yeah, Ace of Cups. It's interesting, right? It's interesting because this person has very deep feelings, strong feelings for you, Aquarius. They do care about you. Okay, they do care. They do care. There are, wow. Okay, so this person is really like, you are heavily on their mind. Okay, they know that in a way they have betrayed your trust, they have betrayed you. They're not proud of it at all. Okay, they're not proud. They're thinking about the times that you shared. Let's see. So this person is holding a cup for you, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. And I did say earlier that they are the ones that have to come with the sword of truth. It's for them. It's time for them. It's their job to speak up, to initiate, to make that phone call, to send that email, to initiate. Yes. And as I said, now I'm repeating, they're aware of it. They're aware of it. Aquarius, there is a sense of loss here from your side. Again, I'm repeating now. Shit, I'm repeating. So, I want to clarify the Three of Wands. The Three of Wands for Aquarius. The Three of Wands. The Three of Wands for Aquarius. Yeah. And it's like you are somehow accepting. It's somehow you are accepting your fate. Destiny. It's like whatever it will be, will be. Whatever will be, will be. Because again, a part of you is waiting from them, is waiting, hoping that they will reach out, that they will come to. And this part of you is like, okay, you know, whatever happens, happens. Like you're like open to both paths, to both paths. The Wheel of Fortune. I really want to clarify this King of Swords with the Ace of Cups, please. Yes. The King of Swords with the Ace of Cups, please. Thank you. So we have the Fool. And the Fool is all about a new beginning. Either way, you're ready for a new beginning with them or without them. Because even if this person was to reach out to you, come towards you, it would not be the same. For you, it would be something new, a new journey with them. Yes, a new beginning with them. You would not take things off from where you ended things. Does that make sense? Yes? So Aquarius, clarifying your energy here. I mean, again, you're very happy. Something is changing in a good way in your 3D life. Again, maybe you're going out with friends. Could be maybe that you're meeting new people. Yeah, we have the Eight of Wands. This is like fast. There is communication here with the Two of Cups and the Eight of Wands. So let's see. This is very interesting. Let's see. Clarifying the Eight of Wands with the Two of Cups. Aquarius, Eight of Wands, Two of Cups. And the Chariot. Six of Swords. It really feels that someone is, yes, look. Because the Chariot, the Six of Swords, and the Eight of Cups is like, you are receiving some kind of news that will make you happy, Aquarius. And I feel that these news have to do with a soulmate wanting to come towards you, travel, see you. Someone that has, it could be a fire sign, a Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. Again, you do share a very strong bond with this person, Aquarius. Clarifying, please, the Two of Cups. Okay. This person feels a lot of, feels burdened. That this person doesn't feel good not being in contact with you. This person doesn't feel comfortable with the distance between the two of you. And they want to like narrow the gap. They don't want to be away. They don't want to be far away from you. They don't want like this no contact, or this, it's like for them it's difficult. They don't want this energy to continue between the two of you, this gap, okay? I'm repeating. Okay, Aquarius, one more. With this, clarifying, please, the Chariot with the Six of Swords. They it feels like they want to work things out. They want to put energy and effort, but it's just like they are preparing, like how they will come towards you. Because they did something wrong. They were the ones that acted immaturely, that did not take things seriously. They were the ones that, yeah, so they are the ones that will have to fix it. So again, it feels, we have Leo energy on the bottom of the deck. So again, it feels like they're finding that strength to collect themselves and be like, okay, how am I going to approach Aquarius? You know, I have to do it in the right way, on the right time. At this time, they're holding back. They're thinking of you, yes. It's like, again, they're preparing, again, they want to find the right time, the right words, because they want victory with you, Aquarius. They want victory with you. Okay? Clarifying, please, the Three of Cups. The Three of Cups for Aquarius. Ace of Pentacles is an opportunity, is a seed, is something new. Again, I feel that, as I said, that this is coming towards you. It has nothing to do with this person. This is something that is yours. That hasn't, that, like, it doesn't have to do with love or whatever. It doesn't have to do with love and romance. This feels like this is your victory, your manifestation. Nine of Wands. Clarifying the Three of Cups. This has to do with your job. Victory again. So you see what I mean? Even though you are going through a battle at this time, because you are going through a battle, yes, you're hurt. You're wounded. Okay, you are. But there is something coming towards you that will bring a lot of happiness and joy. It's like, again, you're climbing some kind of you're like upgrading yourself, upgrading in your work, your reality. This is also new, a new skill, a new, something new. This is also, something is being approved, maybe a loan or something. It's going to be different for each and every one of you. But you are very happy that this is taking place, because you have been waiting for this. Okay? Yes. Now let's see what's the advice message for Aquarius in May. Okay, that was fast. Honoring. I am kind and loving. Change me, divine beloved, into one who honors my emotions. Let me feel my feelings without judgment and then release them. Show me how to be kind and loving to the child inside who needs care. So this is a lot of like self-love. And I mean, everything that is taking place right now in your life, it's taking place for a reason. It feels like this is a new found part of you. Or maybe a part of you that was sleeping. Remember what I said earlier in the reading, in the beginning of the reading, that it's not your loss, but their loss. Maybe this is the first time you ever feel this way. You know, it's like, wow, you know, it's not my loss, it's their loss. And you're like, wow, I've never said this before. I never felt this way before. Aquarius, thank you, Spirit. Divine abundance. You were born to align with love's will. Follow the Tao and serve something beyond ego. Learn to be abundant. Now chase it. Well, you're not chasing anyone or nothing. Everything is coming towards you, Empress energy. It's coming towards you. This is coming towards you. It has to do with your career, your finances, your 3D reality. It's coming towards you. It is your manifestation though. But again, it's like it's coming towards you. And this person, will also come back to you. You're not chasing them. Maybe once upon a time you were. See how you're changing, Aquarius? So, yeah. This is what I got for you. Take care. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye.